モグの皆さん、久しぶりです。ローレンゾイです。今日は私の毎日のスキンケアとメイクを紹介したいと思います。
I like to start off my day by taking a hot bath. And I normally wash my face in the bath and sometimes I'll do a little bit of a face mask. So every day, I wash my face 2 times. So I use this product first.Which is a cleansing balm that really helps to get off all the makeup and any kind of dirty stuff you have on your face. So in the bathtub, I'll take a little bit, put it here.
So with this cleansing balm, this is really good because it has like a really oily texture to it. I try to give myself a little bit of a facial massage.
Okay, I'm gonna go wash this off now because you guys know I'm not actually in a bathroom. I'm back.
And after I wash my face, I put a little bit of Vaseline just on my lips. This kind of helps because I always feel like my lips are really dry, especially in the morning. This helps to kind of wake up my lip skin also.
And then next, I will take this bowl.And I put ice cubes in here, but they already melted, so this is just very cold water now. And I take a washcloth and get it soaked up in this nice cold water. I like to take this cold towel and I do this for like 3 minutes or something. When you put something cold on your face, it really helps to make your pores super tight.Okay, and then I don't think you have to like fully dry your face or anything. When I'm in the bathtub, I don't do this every single day, but I really like to use a face mask as well. Well, I think you can do this either before or after you wash your face, but recently I've been really liking this rice face mask. And I like face masks that are really calming and really help to moisturize my skin. So sometimes I also use this one. This is by Drunk Elephant. This is actually an overnight.Face mask, but if I have a little bit of extra time in the morning, I'll put this on in the morning. And then about once a week, I will do this little facial exfoliant. So I think exfoliating your skin is very important to maintaining it as well. So after I cool my face off, I start by using this oat toner. This is one that I got in the States as well. This is from First Aid Beauty, and this toner is super soothing.Next, this is from a brand called EBM, but I really like it. So I follow up the toner with a serum. See, it's like a very jelly, kind of like watery texture. And then next, after I do that serum, I follow up with this vitamin C serum. This is from Biossance, however you could pronounce that. This is supposed to help with any kind of discoloration you have on your face.So little sunspots and stuff. Just put a little bit. And actually with stuff like vitamin C, I normally just do this in my nighttime routine and try to keep it pretty simple in the morning. So next on the list is this skin cream that I really like from Skin Fix. This is called the Triple Lipid Peptide Cream. So this is going to help to replenish your skin with a lot of proteins, and it's actually pretty nice too because this has a push top, so all the product comes out the top and you don't have to worry about putting your fingers into it. So I'm going to put this on my neck too. And then lastly, which is super, super important, and I think that everyone should use this if they can, this sunscreen is my favorite right now.So sunscreen, this is something that I use whether or not I go outside. And all the products that I use as well, I try to avoid anything that has a fragrance in it. I try to avoid, face washes that really feel like are making your skin tight at the end. And other skincare things, probably drinking a lot of stuff. So that is the end of skincare. If you want to, with this Vaseline as well, some days what I do too, just before I go out, is I just put it on my eyebrows to kind of get everything in place. Okay, moving on to makeup. So the first thing that I do is I really like to use a pretty light BB cream on my face, and then also I've been mixing it with this skin tint recently, and this one has some serum in it. So skincare も入ってるからなんかすごくいいと思う。Hyaluronic acid. And then this BB cream, this is from a Korean brand called Etude House, and this one I've been using since high school. So if you can see here, the one from Etude House is a little bit more yellow than my skin, so I actually mix it with this one because you can see the colors. This one is a little bit more pinkish, which I feel like matches my skin more. And if you have extra, you can put some on your neck too. I use this beauty blender, and you want to get this pretty wet with water, dry it off a little bit, and then gently, if you want to too, you can kind of like spread it a little bit with your hands first so it's easier for the sponge. And then next I go straight to doing my eyebrows. For my eyebrows I'm using this Maybelline Ultra Fluffy powder pencil. First I like to brush up my eyebrows to get a little to figure out what the shape is, and I just fill in my eyebrows from about like two-thirds of the way to the end, because I think whenever I draw my eyebrows here it looks a little bit too heavy for me, and I want to try to keep my eyebrows looking pretty natural but just a little bit more shaped. And I like to do this with my fingers, just run my fingers along under the edges, and I feel like that kind of helps to sharpen it up a little bit and clean it up. And after I finish drawing in the shape of my brows, I use this Legendary Brow from Charlotte Tilbury. This one doesn't have a lot of color in it, so it lets your eyebrows stay pretty natural looking. So yeah, if you can see, I feel like this one's definitely the better eyebrow. Let me tie back my hair actually. Okay, next on the list, we're going to do the eyes. I use this really cute Chanel eyeshadow palette. So I'll take this bright color and gently put that on my whole eyelid. Can you see? A little bit, maybe? And then after that, I take the dark color of the palette. I like to kind of just like blend it out on my hand a little bit to get off the extra. And then if you want to, I like to put a little bit. I think it looks nice. You can put just a little something on the lash line. And then, yes, I continue to blend with my fingers. I think it's nice to just have that little shadow. I haven't been using it as much recently, but sometimes I like to take this Rare Beauty blush and put a little bit of red under my eyes because I really do like the way that looks. I really like to draw a lot, and I always draw characters, and I like to put red under their eyes. So I'm going to do mascara before I do the eyeliner because I just want to show you what it looks like. This is the Dior Show waterproof mascara. I think it looks pretty good. Let me use this little mirror to see better. And this is the look if you only do up to mascara. Okay, now let's put on some eyeliner. Right now I'm using this One Day Tattoo Real Lasting Eyeliner
これは日本のブランドで、多分どこでも買えるだと思うけど。
So for eyeliner, there are so many different ways that you can do it, and it's really important. Like the shape that you do will really change the feeling that you get. And now I'm very into doing straight eyeliner. Okay, I will just show you.
So I put my hand on my cheek here and draw a little triangle here, and then I do the entire eyelid. And I do the angle of my eyeliner so that if my eyebrow and my eyeliner continued, they would probably connect around here.
Okay, so this is one eye. And I always draw my eyeliner in this shape because I very much like to be able to like... I'll do this one quickly for you.
That is how I do my eyeliner.
A couple more things. Okay, so I use this powder by Makeup Forever. And this one is super good. This actually is just translucent, really goes into your skin, and doesn't make anything cakey. So with the Beauty Blender, I take the powder. So that will kind of mattify those parts of your face. And lastly, lips. Yes. So I've been really into, I never really like to do matte lips or anything. I always like to do something that is a little bit shiny. And Dior has this really cute lip glow oil. This is in the color cherry. Oh, berry. It's super light on your lips, so it just gives you a little bit of color. And it feels pretty moisturizing to me. Sometimes I like to use this like cute little glitter eyeshadow, and I'll put some glitter right in the corner of my eye, which helps to draw light in your eyes, I guess. So lastly for the makeup, and what I mentioned earlier, is that I do like to take this oil that I use on my face at night, this skincare, and take a tiny bit wherever you think is like a good point on your face that you want to shine a little bit. Whew, I think that's it though. That is my everyday makeup that I do. I think that the most important thing about makeup is that you do something that you really love and that feels individual to you and makes you feel good. If you want to do eyeliner for 7 years, go for it.
以上です。見てくれてありがとうございます。I hope you have a good day.